Hey everybody, hope you're doing well. Welcome back to another episode of CSGO News. Today was going to be my day off from CSGO News, but there were so many stories out there that I want to talk to all of you guys about. So remember to please leave a comment down below what story you guys have to talk about, and I will surely reply to those comments if I have time for that. Now, first off, I do want to talk about potential Navi changes coming sometime soon. If you guys did see on Navi's own channel, I'll link this video down below for all of you. Seez came out with an interview on the Navi channel itself, and that video is still on there discussing changes coming to Navi in the near future. And Seez said himself that these are necessary changes, and I'll actually show you guys screenshots on screen about that. And he even mentioned Zeus and the need for a new leader on the team, and the new leader could not be himself. And even when the reporter asked him, or the guy that's also part of Navi asked him, do you think Zeus would be a good leader for the team, he himself said yes. Now, even furthermore than this, guys, we had Simple also on Navi, of course. He also confirmed what Seez had said with this tweet on screen. So it does seem pretty much guaranteed that Navi changes will be coming sometime soon in the next few weeks after the major does conclude for teams like Gambit, and of course Flipside also probably going to be involved this shuffle, because I do mean the CIS shuffle will probably be a part of this, because Navi will not be the only team who actually reaps the benefits here. I do think other players will be involved, and those key players I do want to discuss with all of you, but I want you guys to leave your feedback down below, because as of right now, the CIS shuffle and Navi changes could be a large list of things. I think the most obvious change we could see would of course be Zeus going back to Navi, obviously leaving there, being replaced by Simple several months ago, actually last year around this time. And then of course he could be going back there. He already knows the guys there, and I think the most obvious choice would be him replacing either Seez or Edward probably being your more lower performing player there, and of course he would take over, Zeus would take over the new IGL role for the team. But don't forget, we have other star players out there. We have the IGL for Flipside known as Blade, one of their better players. Electronic could also be involved, and then of course the question is, do we involve one of the better Gambit players, especially in recent times throughout this major? Do we involve a Dren? Does he go to Navi somehow? And again, the most obvious choice people are saying right now is that Navi will pick up all these players, and that all the other players will of course go out other places, because Navi has the most money. But it is also possible that Gambit picks up other players. Now again, can Gambit afford Navi players like Simple? Most likely not, but it's gonna be really cool to see what the CIS shuffle does become. And please leave a comment down below what you guys think is gonna happen. I certainly would be really upset though if this does come true. It seems very likely for a CIS shuffle and that Zeus will be a part of it, and it kind of upsets me, because we actually had Zeus tweet out this, his notorious tweet, he will not give up until he wins a mother flipping major. And the real question is, on top of all of this, is if him and Gambit somehow do manage to win the major. Now as of right now, they're playing a best of three with Fnatic in the quarterfinals. At the point of me recording this video, they are up in that series and are likely to win that series. If they win the major by some slim chance still with other heavy hitters in the game right now like Virtus Pro and SK, will this change the shuffle, and will it change Zeus wanting to leave his team? That is the big question. Leave a comment down below what you guys think. Also, another big stories, guys, we had Phantom Lord. I know I've been talking about this way too much. Gonna be my last video about him probably for a little bit, unless I have, you know, unless he does something stupid in the next few days. He actually has come back with a statement video, and I want to touch on what actually happened in that video. I will play the short clip for you guys right now though, and also link that video down below. Phantom Lord is back, and he will also be live streaming today, but here's what he had to say.
Oh shit. How are we gonna...
So yeah, you guys are here watching now because you want to know everything that's been going on with me. You want to know all the details, all the facts. Fuck, I would love to. I really would love to. Now, before you get super disappointed and you're like, oh, fuck this guy, and you just exit out, let me explain kind of why I can't say shit. It's really for the legal stuff.
So just to cover the main points, so you guys don't have to waste your time watching that 6-minute video, which again is linked down below, I want to kind of summarize the main points he made in that. The first of which, apparently he was never in Mexico. I know a long time ago, Richard Lewis reported on this, Phantom Lord partying away up in Mexico. It did seem like he was in some resort, so I'm not really sure the legitimacy of him saying that, but he did go out and say he was never in Mexico. He is not being pursued legally right now, or he's never been to jail, although it does seem by, based off what he could not say, he's definitely under some kind of legal restriction. And that is why, now another main point here, he could not comment on any details of the case right now because of legal restrictions. Obviously, as his attorney or lawyer is telling him not to talk about anything, because they probably know if he says anything wrong, it could be held against him. Now, another main point he also made to say was he was sorry. So that was really good to see that he was sorry about that. Also, on top of that though, he will be, like I mentioned before, 4 live streaming today. At the point of you guys watching this video, it should be around 5 or 6 hours from now, which will be during another best of three for the actual major going on right now. So I will not be watching his live stream. I might tune in and out and wait for you guys to highlight some things and send them clips to me. If anything happens in the stream that you guys want to share with me, please, my Twitter DMs are always open. But yes, Phantom Lord is back. Tell me what you guys think about that. And a long, long time ago, I did mention the ESCA referral scam. If you guys don't remember the details of this, I want to update you all on the actual scandal. So this is my man Mario on screen for all of you, a great guy I had the chance to talk to. And a long time ago, he actually earned $35,000 through ESCA referral program, or the ESCA referral program, referring people to sign up for ESCA, you know, for $6.95, whatever it is per monthly fee. He had so many referrals, he earned almost $35,000, and allegedly ESCA decided not to pay him. So to give you guys details about that, I updated you guys a couple weeks ago. Here's another update for you. He has now teamed up with Video Game Attorney, and he has sent letters of demand to the company ESCA, and they have not responded quite yet. If they decide not to respond by the listed date, which I believe is going to be the 21st of July, so obviously like right now, if they don't respond within the next few days, he's going to decide to go to court with them, and that could cost Mario, our man. I'm on his side, obviously. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I'm the people person. He's the underdog in this case, and it will probably cost him around $10,000 to hook up with a lawyer to actually pursue ESCA in court and try and get his money back. So updates on that, guys. It seems to be going well. A Video Game Attorney has said to Mario that he does have a very solid case there, and as of right now, ESCA has paid Mario $3,500, but still owes him, I think the exact balance is just over $30,700. So crazy to see. I'll keep you guys updated on this. It's gonna be a very, very long case. It's gonna be a very long battle in the courts for ESCA, but it's gonna be very cool to see if Mario can actually get his money back. So best of luck, my friend. I'll keep you guys posted on how that goes. He does have Video Game Attorney on his side, though. Very exciting stuff. And huge shouts. Thank you guys so much. As many of you guys know, I have been partnered with CSGO Swap. I'm not sure if it's gonna be a long-term thing, but their owner has been very generous with me offering this offer to me. So I'm gonna partner up with CSGO Swap, guys. My affiliate link is down below. So if you guys want to trade up your skins, please use my affiliate link down below. And I seriously cannot thank you guys enough. The army has been strong, and I keep on saying thank you. I'm gonna move on. Anyway, to our community question of the day. I am so excited for this segment. We have done this so well. And thank you to all of you guys who asked questions in the comment section and thumbs up other people's questions. From now on, I have a permanent segment on this channel called Community Questions. You guys can comment any question you want. If it gets a lot of thumbs up, I will answer that. So the main one I had on last video a couple times was, where is Hiko, or what is Hiko doing? I announced this a long time ago, but I know a lot of you guys, when you watch my videos, you only watch 4 to 5 minutes and you can miss the smaller stories. So Hiko did announce on stream around a month ago, he is currently making his own North American team, and Hiko, as of a month ago, had at least one North American organization willing to offer him and his team some sort of employment or some sort of money to actually, you know, play for them. So who knows how many teams are going to be offering it as of right now. But updates as well, another community question you guys had is, what about Evil Geniuses? Now this kind of ties together, because I did think that one of the teams that could be interested in potentially Hiko, as they were several years ago before the iBuyPower scandal, could be Evil Geniuses. We had their CEO tweet out this back during the ESL Pro League Finals in late May. He tweeted out he was going to be in Dallas for those Pro League Finals. So it could be Evil Geniuses trying to offer Hiko and a North American team. We'll have to see in the future what happens. So that's what Hiko is doing. He's still streaming, still not playing on a professional team as of right now, but I do believe he's making a team and he will be back to the pro scene sometime soon. Thank you guys all for your community questions, and thank you so much for the great support on my CSGO Swap link. I will not thank you guys enough. As always, I will see you guys all in a couple days. I was supposed to take today off. I'm going to take tomorrow off because there's not going to be enough news to share with you. But I will have another video for you guys on Sunday. Hope you guys all enjoyed. Live, love, laugh a lot. My name is Jake. Remember, I like you. Thank you all so much for the great comments. I'm going to try and reply to every comment today. So comment right now, and I will see you all in a couple days. Remember, I like you. Goodbye. That's such a freaking pansy outro.
Right now, they're going for it. The defuse is already happening. Hiko, are you kidding me? He's going to go for it. They win the race.